Hello, I'm Blake Ress, Commissioner of the Indiana High School Athletic Association. Today, I'd like to tell you about a friend to the more than 160,000 student athletes in the state of Indiana, Farm Bureau Insurance. In their own low-key way, Farm Bureau Insurance has played a key role in the success of high school athletic programs throughout the state. Since joining the IHSAA as its exclusive corporate partner in 1988, Farm Bureau Insurance has contributed more than $3 million in support of high school student athletes. On behalf of all the member schools of the IHSAA, we would like to take this opportunity to thank Farm Bureau Insurance for its support of our young people.
To most of the country, it's just a game played during the winter. But for our Hoosier heritage, this is the time where our fondness for basketball has its yearly renewal. A time where the spirit of the student athlete has been entrusted with our passion of sport and the pureness of its competition. Where hard work is rewarded not with wealth and riches, but with the smiles and the tears of a lifetime. In this state, basketball bonds communities together. It surrounds us, and to this day, conjures up the memories of times past, where a simple game played by young adults can inspire future generations, even after all this time. Now is the time where the hard work and dedication is rewarded, not only of the players, coaches, and staff, but also their families and fans who will also share in these wonderful moments just ahead. Today we celebrate the 32nd annual IHSAA Girls State Finals. Eight teams have made it, four teams will have their young dreams fulfilled. Because the dream of making it to the finals will never wander, no matter where in this state basketball is played. So action continues in the 2007 Girls IHSAA State Finals Basketball Tournament. We've moved our way up to the 3A Championship for the Warriors of Wawasee and the Braves of Brebeuf Jesuit High School. Welcome, everybody. Jerry Baker along with Jane Schott. JMV will join us along the way. You know, we brought two games up and two games down. And as you look at the four games, this game is really kind of hard to get a read on, Jane. Both these clubs pretty equal.
Yeah, you've got number six versus number eight. They're evenly matched. I think it's going to be a hotly contested contest tonight.
Let's take a look at the tournament trail, show you how these teams got here. For Wawasee, under Ken Zolman, they had to beat the number one team in the state last Saturday, South Bend St. Joe, 58-46. Now, they don't score a lot of points, 44 per game, but they're defense is strong at 34-2, an average winning margin of just under 10 points a game. They are 11, number 23, that's Taylor Goshert.
Goshert's the super sophomore. She leads a balanced attack, having 14 points a game and 5 rebounds. I think she's got to lead her team today offensively to get things going for Wawasee.
Head coach Kendall Kreinhagen has the Brebeuf Jesuit Braves set to go. And their tournament trail found them having to go to Jeffersonville last Saturday and beat number 9 Evansville Bossy, the number 9 team at the state, in the semi, 55-53. They score about 60 points a game, their average winning margin about 19 per, and they've got one of the best big ladies in the state in Tashia Phillips.
Well, Phillips is a force inside. She's 6'5 and can finish down low, so I think Wawasee's going to have their hands full with the big senior center tonight.
I'd stay with us. We'll come back, get the keys to the game. The opening tip-off is not that far away. The 3A title coming up next here on the Indiana Cable Network. Back at Conseco, Wawasee at 22-3, Brebeuf Jesuit Preparatory School at 22-6. Jane, let's get a look at the keys to the game for both of these clubs here tonight.
Well, I think they have a little bit of contrasting styles, and Wawasee has got to control the tempo if they want to be successful tonight. If they can keep the scoring low, that bodes well for them because they're a great defensive team. On the other side, Brebeuf wants to establish a post presence, get the ball to Phillips. She has been tearing it up in the tournament, and if they'll stay out of foul trouble, then they'll have a good shot at a championship.
All right, there's Jane's keys to the game. We take another break. When we come back, you'll meet the squads, and then we'll tip things off for the 3A championship here at Conseco. Wawasee and Brebeuf Jesuit coming up next. Ready to go at Conseco. Here's Wawasee starting lineup. The Saturn starting lineups for the Wawasee ball club. Walker, Ort, McAdams, Goshert, and Knafel. That'll be how they'll line them up on that particular side of the line.
Brebeuf Jesuit with Curry, Aisha Newsom, Meadows, Hand, and Phillips. And Tashia is a name we're going to be calling a great deal tonight, I got a feeling, June.
Well, she has really been tearing it up in the tournament. As I said, she's averaging 26 points in postseason play here, and I think she'll really bring her A game. She hung the full championship.
As she'll step in against Sean Knafel, and the opening tip controlled by Brebeuf. Brebeuf Jesuit, 22 wins and 6 losses. The only record that would be worse to win a state championship. A ball club won a title losing 7 games over the regular season, so they can make some near history here tonight. Long range shot is no good. Long rebound comes off on the far side to Jessica Hand. Here's the penetration inside by Curry.
Nice steal there by Phillips. She just kind of cleared a space for Curry to come in for an uncontested layup.
Boy, this is going to be an up-tempo game if early indications or anything at all. Wawasee gets it inside. Nice ball movement. Megan Walker from outside for 3 is off the mark. Tashia Phillips had it momentarily and lost it. Held ball. Possession arrow will give it back to Wawasee. Well, this tempo in the first 45 seconds is pretty quick here.
Well, we'll see.
The coaching staff here, Kendall Kreinhage, gets Kim Zollman, the father of a lady you might have heard of, Shanna Zollman.
Might have heard of her, a great career at Tennessee, and obviously now playing in the WNBA, so one of Indiana's finest for sure.
All-time leading scorer in the girls' side of the ledger. Inside, Tashia Phillips might have changed that shot that time by Kylie Ort. Loose ball in the corner, and Wawasee, a scrappy little bunch, going after that loose ball. Just a minute into the game, and the pace is really, really quick.
Well, Wawasee had one of the toughest routes to get here. They had to knock off number 5, and last weekend, knocked off number 1, South Bend St. Joe, to get down here to the state championship. They played very well together. You know, it's hard to pick the star out because of their balanced attack, and everybody does a little bit of everything.
Well, they had a good look that time, but Brennan McAdams came way out deep, and they found her deep in the corner now. They're looking to go inside, but nothing available in there, so the shot is put up, and off the flange of the rim, and the loose ball picked up again by Wawasee. Rebound fought for and chased down again by Wawasee. They continue to get offensive rebounds. Wild shot way off the mark that time. Might have been impacted a bit by Tashia Phillips, and here comes Brebeuf again. Driving inside, whistle at a blocking foul.
Well, we saw in the morning game the state record for blocks in a state championship game. There's Kendall Kreinhagen, has done an outstanding job with Brebeuf.
Well, she has. I talked to her on Monday, and I said, boy, at the start of the year, I wasn't too sure about you guys. She says, you know, I'm not real sure what happened because they lost their first 2 games of the year by 9 and 10 points. And she said then all of a sudden, things began to come together, and a lot of that was surrounded by Tashia Phillips. Just dominating those games.
Yeah, well, her senior leadership has got to be key for this Brebeuf team, and you're going to see it tonight. When they need a basket, they're going to get the ball inside to her and have her take over.
That personal foul, by the way, was on Kylie Short, her first and the first against the ball club. Baseline shot, left side, 15-footer up and good. That is Brennan McAdams.
And you notice McAdams pulled up short, didn't go all the way out of Phillips. So if you've got to pull up jump shot, that's your best option against Brebeuf's defense.
And much like the first 2 games we've had today, a lot of youngsters on both sides of the ledger. A lot of freshmen, a lot of sophomores. But again, you're looking for that senior leadership, and that's what both clubs have. They try to go to Phillips inside, but the swarming defense by Wawasee. It'll be out of bounds and last touch by Wawasee.
High-low look there by Brebeuf, but you see Wawasee getting around on the baseline. A nice little pull-up jump shot there. Did it to go down to get them on the board.
Well, the 12-man roster for Brebeuf, there are 5 freshmen and sophomores. So they've got a youthful club likewise. Ball kicked away. There are 6 freshmen and or sophomores on the Wawasee 12-player roster. Youngsters both ways. There's Kim Zollman. Inbounds pass, stolen away. Nice pass from Kylie Ort, and an offensive foul, I believe, will go against Brennan McAdams.
Not a tremendous amount of contact, but McAdams a little bit out of control as she takes it in. And Lauren Meadows holds her ground. I guess on the replay, they didn't like that too much. A little bit
early on, a little touch foul, not much contact there.
Kim Yelich, Fred Shude, and Mark Winicky are the officials for our 3A championship game. There's the field goal percentage. Now the ball club shooting well, but there's the lady that can change that to Shia Phillips getting her first 2 points of the game. Phillips coming in averaging 21.3 and 15.2 rebounds per game. Out of bounds belongs to Brebeuf Jesuit.
Well, you see Phillips establishing that low post. When she gets within 2 or 3 feet of the basket, you might as well go to the other end. Kelly Curry doing a nice job of lofting it up top. Not a defender can stop that as she gets too low. You cannot let her have that position. I know she's big, but you got to try to body her. You see them trying to do it again, and that's time unsuccessful.
Second turnover now for Wawasee, for Brebeuf, I should say. No foul. The officials at this particular point in time letting them play and throwing away. And last touch by Brebeuf Jesuit.
At this point, both crowds upset. Brebeuf wanting a turnover. And behind us, the Wawasee crowd thought there was some contact there with Tashia Phillips. You know, Phillips is 6'5". I'm not sure if they've noticed. She can block a shot without getting any body contact. I wasn't down there, but it looked pretty clean up top.
Well, the pace of the game right from the get-go has been very, very quick. And the officials having their hands full right now until things kind of settle in. Nice movement by Wawasee. The pull-up 10-footer on the left side's good. That's Taylor Goshert averaging 14.2, getting her first couple of points in the game. And right now the score goes 6-4 in favor of Brebeuf Jesuit. They average 59.1, Wawasee at 50.2. So you'd expect the game to be somewhere in the 50s. Long range three rattles in, rattles out by the Caroline Curry long range jump shot and out of bounds.
Big time rebound by Tashia Phillips. I thought that shot was gonna go down and it pops out. Phillips pursues the rebound and you see her get on the inside of the defense. Once that happens, it's not that they can't do it. Wawasee can't do much about that. And they just tried to body her and you almost let her go. I give her a layup, although she's not a great free throw shooter, so she misses that.
Foul was on McAdams with her second, so right away they're going to have to make a substitution on the Wawasee side of things. And a foul down in the corner as they try to penetrate. The foul's going to go on number 10. That'll be Aisha Newsom, number one on her. So with 3:42 to go in the opening quarter, we'll get some substitutions. We'll also get a timeout. Brebeuf leads by an 8-4 score. Jerry Baker, Jane Schott, and JMV on hand at Conseco Fieldhouse for the 3A championship. Stick around because this game is going to be right to the wire. You get that feeling. And then coming up next, a real battle. South Bend, Washington, and Columbus East. They have two of the most outstanding individuals on either team that you're going to see all year long. And we'll have it for you live here on the Indiana Cable Network. Now, Brebeuf played Wawasee earlier this year in the Wawasee shootout. Brebeuf winning at 58-53. Phillips had 22 points. Obeime, 16. Wolf, Knapel, and Walker each had 9 for Wawasee in that game. Here's the long shot off the mark. Chased down by Brebeuf. And the Braves will get it back across the court. Much like the first couple of games, full court pressure being employed by Wawasee to kind of slow things down a little bit.
Yeah, you can't let Brebeuf come down and set up in the half court. That time, Phillips, she's way far away from the basket. Gets another turnover. That's 4 for Brebeuf so far.
Penetration inside, but nice defense that time. That was the number 10, Aisha Newsom, the freshman who stepped down to the baseline and kind of shut things off down there. 3 minutes to play here in the first quarter in an 8-4 ball game. Brebeuf Jesuit leading Wawasee 8-4. Inside, Phillips. You cannot stop her from in there, but she can stop herself. She misses the shot, almost a gimme.
Nice high-low look there on the dunk down inside. The pass from Obeime.
Coming into this game in tournament play, Tashia Phillips has scored 157 points. That's an average of 26.2 per game.
Well, that's to go along with 16 rebounds a game and 4 blocks. She has really stepped up her play. She looks hungry when you're watching. It's in her eyes. She wants a championship, and we'll see if she can get that tonight.
Kayla Lance is in the lineup now for Wawasee. A 5'6 junior has played in 25 games. Held ball, possession arrow will go to Brebeuf. Brebeuf principal, Dr. Matthew Hayes, also the superintendent. Mike Marshall is their new AD at Brebeuf Preparatory School. They're independent. Enrollment of about 817. School colors, maroon and gold. They're located on the north side of Indianapolis, up on West 86th Street. Got a nice campus up there.
Wawasee extending their pressure a little bit there in a 1-2-2 zone, and they're meeting him at the half court now, trying to not allow Brebeuf to dump it inside.
Going away. Lance that time thought she had somebody down low and couldn't find anybody down there. Wawasee's principal, Ellen Stevens. Dr. Mark Stock is the superintendent. Mary Hurley, the AD. Members of the Northern Lakes Conference, Forest Green and Old Gold, their school colors, enrollment of 1,092, and they're about 167 miles north of Indianapolis.
Both teams just look a little rattled right now to start the game. Five turnovers apiece, and we've played it just about 6 minutes, so they're averaging almost a turnover a minute. Need to settle down and just settle into their games.
8-4 is your score now with Brebeuf on top. Low scoring in the early going of this game. Bank shot up and good, Kaylin Lance. Lance is the young lady who came in when Brennan McAdams picked up that second personal foul. Lance, a 5'6 junior. At the other end, they've got it from the big now.
Wow, that's pretty scary, Jerry. She just showed another element of a game. If you're 6'5 and can run the floor like that and lay it in off the dribble, that's outstanding. You saw a new dimension there of Tashia Phillips.
Well, they've got to keep an eye on her. It's a little like the opening game that we had today. You've got to focus. You know where she is all the time, both offensively and defensively.
Right now, Wawasee just trying to work the basketball till they get a good shot. That's not bad. They probably can get a different look. And
well, Brebeuf had it momentarily. Caroline Curry did, and apparently stepped on the baseline, so the ball goes over to Wawasee.
I thought they were going to get a foul.
I was looking for the personal foul.
She dove after it. And there's Phillips getting it in transition, puts the ball on the floor in stride and lays it in. A great move by Tashia Phillips.
3-point shot by Goshert off the mark. The sophomore missing the gag, gets her own rebound. It comes back outside. Another 3-pointer in the sky, and this time it's good. It's Megan Walker.
Offensive rebounds are hurting Brebeuf right now. That is the fifth offensive board for Wawasee, and this time they turn it into points.
And they chuck the lead to one from 4-1, just like that. And time is running out here in the first quarter of play. Corner, right side, air ball thrown up there. Nowhere near, and off into the hands of the green-shirted Wawasee Warriors. Wawasee coming back, trying to take the lead for the first time with 20 seconds to go here in the opening quarter. Tipped away, but last touch by Brebeuf. And a substitution for Brebeuf into the lineup. Number 33, Paige Thomas. She's a junior, stands 5'6", has played in 27 of the 28 games this year, averaging right at 4 per game.
They're also going to get Jessica Hand back in for Tashia Phillips. They try to give her a break around the quarter so that she can have a little bit extra time to catch her breath, because she's not going to come off the floor very much. She's anytime you got a post player, it's got to run the floor, you know, all the whole game, it makes it difficult, so you try to get him a few extra breaks.
Already into the lineup, Tara Weiser, 5'11 freshman for Wawasee, wearing number 42. Clock down to 7 seconds right now, looking to get a good shot. They bounce it into the post. Here's the shot by Ort. No good. Patty couldn't get it. And that's going to pretty much take care of the end of the first quarter, and it does. So it was kind of a harum-scarum first quarter, kind of wild, kind of quick in both directions. But after one, it's Brebeuf 10 and Wawasee 9 for the 3A IHSAA championship. As we get set to begin the second quarter, let's bring in the third member of our crew, John Michael Vincent, JMV.
Hey, Jay Baker, thank you very much. You know, behind the bench during the timeout there, Kendall Kreinhagen, the head coach of Brebeuf, not too happy about getting out scrapped in what she termed in that first quarter, even though they had the 1-point advantage. Not happy the way her team is playing. Settle down, get it into Tashia Phillips, and see what happens from there. That's what they're going with here in the second quarter. Bake, back to you.
Thank you very much, JMV. Yeah, Kendall, She looks like one of the players. What she looks like, she has an 11-month-old child. And I said, talked to her mother. I said, "You're going to bring him to the game?" Oh yeah. Right in front of the Brebeuf bench. Personal foul. Paige Thomas. One on her. Kendall spending her fifth year at the school, a record of 97-33. She's won 75% of her games.
Well, she's a fiery coach for sure, and if her team is getting out hustled, that definitely does not pose well with her style of play. So she's getting after him, and then you see it results in a steal by Callie Curry.
Curry going in, and she'll draw the personal foul from Taylor Goshert. That'll be the first on Goshert.
Well, Goshert thought she got all ball, but Callie Curry did the right thing. When she got the steal, she's going straight to the hoop. She sees Gosher retreating, and you take it at her. You saw that same kind of call on the other end. The officials, I think, are putting it pretty tight right now to clean play up.
Third point for Caroline Curry. These two clubs we talked about met earlier this year, and it was a weight of a game of 58-53 in favor of Brebeuf, and it looks to me like we're looking at the same kind of a scenario here in this 3A championship game here at Conseco Fieldhouse.
Well, we predicted it to be the closest of all of them, and they're living up to it so far with the 11-10 first quarter.
Phillips from behind.
Well, two block shots there. Curry gets one on the perimeter jump shot. The ball gets tipped into Wawasee's hand, and then along comes Tashia Phillips. So you see the first block there. Phillips comes around. Gosher trying to get to the basket on her. Phillips just kind of hounds her, knocks it out of bounds.
Jesse Wolf, number 40, a 5'11 senior, coming into the lineup for the first time for Wawasee. And Sean Knapel coming back into the lineup. There are the block shots. Brebeuf 4-0. And out of bounds to Wawasee.
Well, you would expect Phillips with the 6'5 size advantage to dominate in the interior. She's already got three block shots. We're going to have to keep an eye on that. We've already broke a record once in terms of block shots today. We'll see if Phillips can top it.
A minute gone here in the second quarter. And they're going to have the turnover over and back. It's interesting, if you watch next time that Brebeuf is on defense, as you look at Kim Zolman in his ninth year at the school, 141-65, winning percentage of 68%. Next time you see Brebeuf on defense, what you're going to see is Tashia Phillips kind of, she just sort of positions herself, Jane, and says, I'm going to block anything that comes in the middle, and they're trying to work around the perimeter, and it's just not working right now. There she is inside, got the roll.
Well, they're probably going to score on a good percentage of their out-of-bounds plays underneath, because you can get Phillips on the lob play. Wawasee doesn't have anybody. Knapel is their tallest player, and she stands 6'1", but she's pretty slight of frame. She's not going to body with Phillips down low, so Wawasee's going to have to really figure out a way to serve Phillips on the inside.
Three-point shot, is it? From the corner, deep left side. Gosher, they're going to call it just a two, so it's 14-11. They had their biggest lead at five. And now it is knocked down, and the loose ball picked up, and Phillips will get the shot, get the bucket, and go to the line.
Phillips showing a lot of emotion right now. You can tell she really wants this. You see her here on the out-of-bounds play, looking for the lob. Three jerseys around her, they don't even disturb her. And then this time, Callie Curry gets it down, and Aaron Pass ends up in Phillips' hand, and she gets fouled, so she's going to go to the line for the old-fashioned three-point play.
Phillips now with 10, and that's all. She misses the free throw. It's knocked out of bounds, and last touch by Brebeuf. Substitution back into the lineup now for Brebeuf. We're coming in for the first time, Ivie Obeime, 5'10 junior, wearing number 25. She's participated in some 27 of their 28 games. Ivie Obeime, number 25, into the lineup for Brebeuf.
Right now, Brebeuf going to a little half-court trap, trying to catch Wawasee off guard. It's working so far. They look out of sync.
They had a whistle. Did they call timeout?
I think Ken Zolman got the timeout because he saw his team was really just frantic. They didn't expect the half-court trap. They didn't know where to go. It did toss out of it, but they were definitely out of control.
Here's a reminder for you to join us on the 10th of March. We'll be live, that's on Saturday, at the Hinkle Fieldhouse, bringing you the regional championship game of the guys. Obviously, at this particular point in time, we don't know who's going to play because they're playing the sectional championships tonight. Then they'll have the semifinal games that afternoon. And then John Laskowski and I will be on hand on Saturday night at 8 for the boys' regional. And Jane and I talked about this earlier with the field that's coming into that particular regional. That's almost like a state championship game.
Yeah, I think it'll be a lot of fun. I mean, I think the sectionals and the regionals, you get a lot of rivalry and a lot of flavor. It's going to be fun to watch as the boys' tournament unfolds. You saw it in the girls, you'd expect it in the boys as well.
Well, a lot of defensive pressure employed by Brebeuf. You just can't, you just don't room to breathe out there right now. That's a good move inside, though, by Kylie Ort.
The sophomore averages 3 points a game, and she likes to penetrate. She's very good at that pull-up jumper and looks confident in that shot.
Ashley and Kylie are sisters. There's the ball deflected out of bounds. Kaylin Lance yelling up the crowd behind her there, trying to get them into the ball game. Got a nice crowd on hand on both sides of the floor tonight. You'll see some empty seats because they belong to the South Bend Washington or the Columbus East fans. So don't think that there's not a lot of fans here because they have their own section and they are there and they're decked out in their school colors. 5 minutes, 24 seconds to go here in this first half, and a 16-13 lead by Brebeuf. They've had the lead at five. And no lead changes and no ties so far. Ball hawking defense by the sophomore, Kylie Ort.
They're going to get Brebeuf, Callie Curry. That's an interesting call. Wallacey loves it, Brebeuf doesn't. Both players going hard after the basketball. And they pick up Callie Curry for the foul. As you see, she's trying to secure it and knocks Lance down and going for the basketball.
Curry getting her first foul. She has 4 points. She's one of the top scorers in the club at 10.9.
You see Brebeuf in the 1-2-2 half court trap right there, and Taylor Goshert went to the wrong place. You don't go across the half court there on the sideline for fear of getting trapped up, and that's exactly what happened. She gets a turnover.
And there's just pressure everywhere right now. Shot off the side of the board by Curry. Loose ball chased down and out of bounds. It'll be Wawasee's basketball.
Good hustle play. Tashia Phillips getting a lot of attention inside. Lost her footing and had to just kind of flip the ball out. Obeime really gave a good effort to try to save it in bounds, but couldn't get there in time.
Good job by Lance that time to get out of that corner. When that happens over there, you've got the timeline and the out-of-bounds line as added defender for you.
Yep, and now they're doing it on the baseline. So it's a half-court trap where they try to trap you as you come across the half, and then if you get it down to the baseline, they're going to trap you down in that corner. So all corners are working for trap spots for the Brebeuf Brave right now. Wawasee has got to get the ball to the middle. That's the way you attack a 1-2-2.
Well, you expect a low-scoring game. Brebeuf allows only 48 points a game. Wawasee only 37 a game. It was kind of what we expected at this particular juncture. 4 minutes and a few seconds to go in the first half, and a foul outside. Curry again. That's number two on her.
That's a big foul for Curry. She is their junior point guard. She kind of runs the show. She controls the tempo. She does a good job of feeding Phillips.
Two shots for Kaylin Lance.
And now she has two fouls. So she, if they're going to leave her in the game, she's got to be very careful. And I think they're probably going to sub for her, and they do.
Kaylin Lance gets the first free throw. Yes, she will go out of the lineup right now and come and get in her spot, 33 Paige Thomas.
Watch to see how this plays out, but I think that's going to move Newsom to the point guard position. And that's a freshman assuming the point guard role for Brebeuf against this pressure. We'll have to see how she can handle that pressure.
Those are the first two free throws by the Wawasee Warriors. Here comes that pressure again. They pick them up about three-quarter court. Halfway through the second quarter, inside Tashia. Banks it off the glass, gets the roll.
Signature shot there for Tashia Phillips. She likes to turn to the middle. Gets a little dribble to gather herself. And she knocks it home off the glass. A nice move by the big center.
And Phillips comes out defensively at the other end. It clogs things up, stops on the baseline. May have gotten the credit for a block shot there. Nice return, though, by Sean Knapel, but to no avail. And Brebeuf gets the ball, basketball back again. Brebeuf Braves looking for the state championship. They have one other to their credit 3 years ago, back in 2004. Now 3.5 minutes to go in the half. On the floor, loose ball, and picked up by Brebeuf. And in the process of chasing it down, another personal foul is going to be called.
I believe they're going to get Kaylin Lance. She was the one that was right there trying to pick the ball up. Just a little bit of body contact. I think, you know, as a player, you have to adjust. And
yep.
Officials are calling a little tight.
That's her first personal foul.
Official timeout is taken.
Well, timeout with 3:22 to go in an 18-15 ball game. Brebeuf Jesuit over Wawasee. Jane and I were just talking. Tim Edwards, doing our stats for us, pointed out that the record for 3A block shots is 4 by Natalie Will of Northwood in 99 and Katie Gerald of Beech Grove in 2003. But that record got destroyed overall today by... I've forgotten her name.
Oh, Katie Cochran.
Katie Cochran,
from Wood Memorial. She had 10 block shots within her triple-double. She had a phenomenal game, even though could not lead her team to a championship. We'll see if Tashia Phillips can have that record be the shortest standing block shot record in the history and see if she can beat that tonight.
Here she is inside. Shot is short. Goes for the rebound. Ball batted around. She stays right with it, but there's another whistle and another foul.
I believe they're going to get Obeime on that. Or no, excuse me. Check that. It should be on Jessica Hand, I think.
It is on Jessica. Yeah, that's the first on her.
Her and Phillips really pursuing hard on the offensive glass. Just bodied Wawasee underneath.
Yeah, if you weren't with us earlier today for Oakland City Wood Memorial, just a phenomenal game by senior Katie Cochran. 17 points. 13 rebounds and 10 block shots. Traveling violation, no bucket. And that 10 blocks set the record, not just for class 1 or 2, but for all 4 classifications. She was phenomenal.
Amber Harris from North Central held that record with 9, so she broke it by 1. Tashia Phillips has already tied the class 3A blocks, and we are not even to halftime yet. That last time down, she didn't get the block, but she caused Goshert to travel because she was coming to get the block.
We're in the midst of the Class 3A championship game. Brebeuf wearing those gold uniforms. Wawasee in the green. It was 10-9 at the end of the first quarter with Brebeuf on top. Now it's 18-15. Brebeuf Jesuit still in the lead, and that's one of the reasons why. Tashia Phillips now with 14 points.
A great feed inside by Lauren Meadows. Giving it to the big girl right on the dime at the right spot at the right time so that she can make her move and score uncontested.
They are giving Wawasee open looks outside, daring him to come inside. But Tashia Phillips' presence in there says, I don't think so. So if that outside shot is working, great. If not, you've got a little bit of a problem. Here's the long-range shot off the mark and chased down in the corner. Last touched out of bounds. Should have been touched by Jesse Wolf, and indeed it was. So Aisha Newsom, the 5'5 freshman, will toss it in. Double substitution now.
22,
out of the lineup goes Paige Thomas for Brebeuf. Into the ball game is 22, Tiffany Bird.
Well, oddly enough, you would think with Brebeuf's size, they would be out rebounding Wawasee right now. But Wawasee's got 9 offensive rebounds. Those long shots are resulting in long rebounds, and Brebeuf is not securing them.
Now to a minute 45 here in the first half. Offensive rebounds. Wawasee with 9 for 3 points. Brebeuf has 4 offensive boards that they turned into 4 points in this game. Minute and a half to play in the half. 5-point lead. Brebeuf has never trailed in this contest. The blocking foul. The bucket is good. We'll wait for the call, but it looks like Tiffany Bird's going to pick up the personal foul.
Yeah, she came over on the help side defense. Got there a little bit late. So you see right there, Kaylin Lance taking it hard to the basket. And yes, she did clobber going into her hard, but because Bird was not set, the foul's going to go on a blocking foul to Bird.
Lance has tried the only 2 free throws thus far for Wawasee. See some numbers on the screen for her. She is good on all 3 of her attempts. 7 points now for Kaylin. That's well above her average. A 5.3, so she's having a good first half right now. In fact, she's the top scorer for Wawasee. Full court pressure again. And it's been that way right from the get-go. Nice steal that time by Kylie Orr. They'll come back the other way with Goshert in control. Bring it back out at the point. Open in the corner. Nice head fake. Moving inside is Kylie Orr. And they keep it alive. Down to 1 minute to go in the half.
Well, if you're all to see, you're thinking, Kylie Orr, I got past Phillips, and then Hand got me with the block. So tough to get anything on the interior right now against the Braves.
Well, a nice head fake, and the shot no good. The putback is blocked, but a foul is going to be called prior to the block.
Tashia Phillips got a nice block up top, but they're going to get the foul on Tiffany Bird with the body foul on on the offensive glass. First, second, again, Wawasee Warriors just being Warriors on the boards. I'll tell you, their offensive board work is really hurting Brebeuf, and it's keeping Wawasee in the basketball game, because if you look at their shooting percentage right now, it is not the greatest at 25%, but because they have 11 offensive rebounds, they're staying close.
Paige Thomas coming back into the game for Brebeuf, replacing Tiffany Bird, number 22. Substitution now for Wawasee into the lineup. Number 12, Megan Walker. She'll come in for Taylor Goshert. Goshert going out with only 4 points so far, and she's one of the young ladies we were focused on at the start of the telecast. Free throws up. It is off the mark. That's the first miss of the ball game by Jesse Wolf. And a held ball. Possession error will get the ball to the ball.
But again, and you can see Kendall Kreinhagen on the sideline urging her team to block out, because again, Wawasee almost got another offensive rebound that time off the free throw.
Brebeuf earlier this year against South Bend Riley on the 13th of January scored 103 points. Now they turn the ball over again. So they can score even though their average is 59.1. And this is a situation, we saw this in the first couple of games, Jane, where we felt like both clubs had a little trouble getting, all four clubs had trouble getting settled down. And I think I'm seeing the same thing here. The pace of the game is so quick that they just can't get to run the plays they want to run, it seems like.
Yeah, they're just a little too quick. The defense is dominating right now, and offense looks very sloppy. 12 first half turnovers for Brebeuf and 9 for Wawasee.
Neither coach is going to be particularly happy about that. 1 point ball game though, with 30 seconds to play in the half. At one time, a 5 point lead for Brebeuf. And we'll see what Wawasee wants to do here to play for the final shot, perhaps, at the first half. JMV will be talking with the coaches at halftime, get their thoughts on how this game has progressed. Here's the ball batted free into the backcourt. Last touch by Brebeuf. Clock down now to 11. Well, they just can't even get free for a shot. Lance gets down into the corner, gets double team, gets triple team, has the ball stolen away, and stepping on the baseline, one of the Brebeuf players, and Ivie Obeime. So with 4.7 to go, it'll be Wawasee's ball under their own hoop. See if they can get free and get some kind of a shot. Uncontested, not going to happen. Stolen away by Brebeuf, and a foul with 1 second to go.
Aisha Newsom, the freshman, making a nice defensive play on the inbound. Taylor Goshert looking for an open player. Couldn't find one. Tries to get it up top to Megan Walker, and that's when Newsom came in and goes hard to the basket. Picks up the foul. With only 1 second left on the clock.
Newsom has not scored in the game. She averages just under 3 points a game. At the line, she's only a 55% free throw shooter.
Well, the good news is, only being a freshman, she's got plenty of time to work on that aspect of her game.
But don't tell Kendall that right now. I don't think she's buying any of that.
No, coaches never do, you know.
And she missed them both. And that's going to take care of the first half of this ball game. Phillips 7 out of 9 from the field, and the rest of the team was 1 of 8. So Phillips has been the player that has really taken care of things. She had 6 points in the first quarter, 8 in the second, for a total of 14. Her average is 21-3. And at halftime, it's a 20-19 ball game in favor of Brebeuf over Wawasee. Let's go to JMV.
Yeah, thank you, Jerry Baker. Well, coach, you're up by 1 at the half. This has been a grind, to say the least. Is this what you expected?
It is what we expected. But, you know, right now, what we've got to make sure we're doing is focusing on our rebounding. Right now, we're not rebounding very well. They're sticking 2 and 3 people on Phillips, and we're not used to her not getting the rebounds. So the rest of us got to go.
Second half, shoot the ball more. Shoot the ball better. I mean, what are you looking for outside of just trying to outscrap Wawasee? Yeah.
You know, we're looking. We're missing a lot of the inside pass to Phillips right now. She's getting position, and we're going away from her, and that's where we want to get the ball. That's our bread and butter, and that's what we got to do.
Coach, good luck in the second half.
Thank you.
Bake, back to you.
All right, Kendall Kreinhagen. She'll go to the locker room along with the other coaching staffs, see what they can do about it. Halftime 20-19. 3A title is up for grabs. We had suggested this is going to be a low-scoring game, and indeed that is the case. Both ball clubs scoring 10 points in the second quarter to make it a 20-19 lead for Brebeuf Jesuit. Time for my favorite part of the telecast is Quiz the Expert. At the start of the telecast, we asked Jane to pick out the keys to the game and her expert, ability. She did so. Now Let's put them up and see what is happening, if indeed we are correct or not, Jane.
See how I did. Well, one thing I know for sure, Brebeuf has done a decent job of establishing the post. They've gotten 14 points from Tashia Phillips, but Kendall Kreinhagen wants more, and I agree with her. You got to go to your bread and butter, get the ball inside. They've stayed out of foul trouble. They're up by one. I think Wawasee has controlled the tempo, and the low-scoring game favors them because you cannot let Phillips and Brebeuf go off offensively. So just like we predicted, a great matchup. We'll see who comes out in the end.
All right. Phillips, 7 of 9 from the field. The rest of the team, 1 of 8. That's been the big story. 1-point lead. We'll come back with more. The 3A title is on the line on the Indiana Cable Network.
Hey, welcome back to Kaseko Fieldhouse. So once again, the 3A title game at the half. Brebeuf, a 1-point advantage, 20-19 over Wawasee, joined on the floor by the stars, Pat McKee, the high school guru. This first half, and I talked to one of the coaches so far, and it was a grind, to say the least. Is it the offense? Is it the defense? What's the overriding factor in what we witnessed so far in this first half of play?
I think it's familiarity. They've played earlier in the season to a 5-point game, and they kind of each know what each other will do, and therefore they're really set to take things away from each other, and it's made it a real kind of ugly game.
You know, idealistically, I guess in a really good world, you would like to see Wawasee have a player that could pull Tashia Phillips out from underneath the hoop because she is such a presence down low. Is that what you're drawing up if you're in that halftime locker room right now to try to counter defensively what Brebeuf does?
Well, if you've got a player who has a little bit of size who can step out and hit some shots and force her to step out, that obviously would be a plus for your team. I'm not sure Wawasee has that player. On the other side, Brebeuf clearly wants to get it to her as much as they can and allow her on the defensive end to roam and block a shot here or there and certainly grab rebounds and limit Wawasee to one shot at a time.
What do you see here in the second half?
Well, Brebeuf has had a history of kind of playing slug-it-out games and pulling away down the stretch. If they keep that up, that would be a good sign for them. I'm sure Wawasee will do everything it can do to counter that.
He is Pat McKee of the Indianapolis Star. Once again, we are at the half. 2019 Brebeuf leading Wawasee the 3A title game. Back at the Fieldhouse next on the Indiana Cable Network.
We are back now at Kateko Fieldhouse for the 3A championship. Time for the Ball State halftime report. And in this halftime report, we take a look at some numbers. What you're going to find, we'll take the highlights first. Let's go to some of the highlights in this game. With both teams not shooting particularly well, but still some highlights.
Thanks to Callie Curry getting on the inside by a screen there by Tashia Phillips. And then Wawasee responds with a little jump shot. Phillips on the inside has been a presence. The two-footer going down very easily. And you see her there with the offensive putback, and she gets fouled to go to the free throw line. Wawasee, though, had a little bit of nice shooting of their own. You see Megan Walker picking up the shot, but Phillips has been a presence inside with the block shot there, altering shots. Kylie Ort got on the inside to get a pull-up jump shot, and then Phillips gets a turnaround for the post move inside.
Here are the first half numbers. I talked about shooting 7 of 28 for Wawasee. That will not get it done. 8 of 17, that's acceptable if you're a Brebeuf Jesuit fan. Rebounds 11 to 5 on the offensive board. Wawasee doing a nice job there.
Well, they need to be. If they're going to shoot 25%, then they have to hit the offensive glass on the other side. Brebeuf shooting a higher percentage, so it's been a very, very close contest so far.
Phillips with 14 points on 7 of 9 shooting. She has 4 block shots. Leading score for Wawasee with 7 is Lance. Back in a minute. 2019 score at halftime. Kim Zollman is the coach of the Wawasee Warriors. He's with JMV.
Thank you very much, Jerry Baker. All right, Coach, what are you doing in the second half? The first half has been a grind. You're only down by a point.
Well, we just got to get the top coming down on our defense a little bit better. We got to get those kids to help our low people. And offensively, we just got to take care of the basketball better and make our offensive possessions count more.
Well, good luck to you in the second half, too.
Thanks very much.
Jerry Baker, back to you.
Wawasee in the green uniforms. The goal belongs to Brebeuf Jesuit. They got the ball inside and they've got the lead. Sean Tenapel getting her first 2 points of the game. And that is the first lead change of the game. The first time that Wawasee has been ahead in this contest. They trail by as many as 5.
Well, they did a much better job of working the basketball around and making Brebeuf's defense move.
Nice offensive rebound and a nice put back by Lauren Meadows. Meadows now with 4 points to her credit so far in this game.
I think Lauren must have heard Coach Kreinhagen's plea for rebounding. She talked about that at the half because Wawasee really hurting her butt on the boards.
Wide open look for three that rattles out of there. And look at the number of gold shirts in there. They're all five of the young ladies were going in after that rebound that time. Time to put a stop to the offensive rebounding prowess of Wawasee. Leading scorer, you see Tashia Phillips with 14. She had 6 in the first and 8 in the second.
Right now you see Wawasee trying to penetrate, but they don't go very deep because they know the 6'5 Phillips back there, the shot blocker, looking to alter the shot.
And almost falling down and knocking down the three is Taylor Goshert. That's only the second three-pointer of the game. She has one, Walker has the other, and it's 24-22, and that is the biggest lead of the night for Wawasee. Inside, Phillips.
Wawasee has gone to man-to-man. At least it looked like that time down. So that leaves Knafel by herself down there against Phillips. And that's a tough matchup. Knafel is 6'1", but she is not quite the same build as Tashia Phillips. As you see Phillips just body and muscle her way down to the low block, and Knafel doesn't have much of an answer.
Fouls on McAdams for Wawasee. Foul number 3 on her. Tashia trying to get the three-point play, does. 17 points now for Tashia Phillips, coming into the game averaging 21.3. Here's the leading scorer now for Wawasee with Lance with 7. They had 6 players score in the first half, so they kind of shared things, if you will.
The balanced attack for the Warriors has been what they've had all season long. Their leading scorer, Taylor Goshert, but everybody chips in.
25-24, Brebeuf. With the lead on defense, stolen away. Nice play that time by Aichi Newsom. He's 5'5 freshman.
Newsom has 2 steals on the night.
Gally Curry got it inside to the big gal, Tashia Phillips, and Phillips finishes up the deal. 19 points now for Tashia. And we got a timeout by Wawasee. A full timeout. He wants the full 60 seconds, does Kim Zolman, so we'll take a break ourselves. 5 minutes and 41 seconds to play in this third quarter. 27-24 lead, Brebeuf over Wawasee for the 3A championship. Three-point ball game now with Brebeuf hanging in there. After leading the entire first half, we've had 3 lead changes in the second half. Wawasee up by a couple of points at one juncture, but right now they trail by 3, 27-24.
Well, a 5-0 run for Brebeuf calls that timeout. Tashia Phillips has all 5 of those points.
And Tashia right now is the dominant factor at both ends of the court. She's playing full court defense right now and blowing right by her, getting the offense set up. Brendan McAdams. And a steal. Try to go coast to coast, and she will. Nice play that time by Ivie Obeime.
Turnover starting to mount for Wawasee. Coach Zolman talked about it at the half. Got to take care of the basketballs and take better have better offensive possessions, and they have not done that here in the second half either.
So Brebeuf has now equaled the biggest lead it's had in the ball game at 5 after being down by a couple. 29-24 is your score. Off the mark, rebounds comes up to Obeime. The 5'10 junior averaging about 4 rebounds per game. And they throw it away. Another turnover. On this run, 7-0. And that's been the big part of the ball game.
You see right there trying to kick the ball out, and Obeime just reads it. Nice denial defense. The outside hand, she takes it hard to the glass and gets the easy bucket. That's the 12th turnover for Wawasee. Now, Brebeuf's not much better. They've got 13. We talked about how sluggish and sloppy this game has become.
Well, Pat McKee at halftime used the word ugly, and that's appropriate. That doesn't mean it's a bad game.
No.
It's just an ugly style game, and sometimes you got to win an ugly game.
Well, you would expect, with both teams being such great defensive in terms of holding their opponents to low scoring, you expect that kind of game.
Yeah, this is not at all unexpected. Here's the 3, and it goes. Nice shot by Brenna McAdams. That's her first field goal since the first quarter. That is her 11th three-pointer on the year, but a big one. And it's 29-27 now in favor of the Buff. They go inside to Phillips. He got nowhere to go. Brings it back outside. The three-point answer, nothing doing. Phillips comes off of the offensive board, gets the bucket, draws the foul, goes to the line.
Well, Phillips is a very good player and extremely intelligent. You can see her. She kicks it out to Callie Curry, who just couldn't get it to go down. As soon as Phillips kicked it, she went down to get an offensive glass position. You know, Kendall Kreinhagen talked about Phillips establishing position. She has very good footwork for a big player, not only on the offensive post moves, but also in terms of establishing position for offensive rebounds. That's her second putback of the night.
Phillips at the line is one of two. Rebound offensively by Brebeuf. Loose ball. Picked up by Wawasee. Another whistle and a holding call.
I think they're going to get Obeime, right?
That is correct. And that'll be Ivy's first personal foul. We've been talking about Tashia. And against Southmont of the sectional, she became the school's girls' career scoring leader. She had 1,910 points coming into this championship. At the other end, and McAdams makes them pay. After getting only 2 points in the first half, she's picked up five in the third quarter alone for seven total. And it's a 31-29 game again.
She went coast to coast. Brebeuf has not been very effective with that full court pressure.
They left Meadows wide open, and she knocks down her 52nd three-pointer of the year, her first in the game, 7 points for her. And at the other end, to get the answer from 23, Taylor Goshert.
It's just back and forth with threes right now. We'll see what Brebeuf does this time. They don't get a three, but they still got the score.
That's Obeime. Ivy with a good move down to the baseline. Well, there's not a lot of chance to set up any kind of an offense. They're just letting them fly. Long range shot, grabs rim, nothing else. Personal foul, it should be on Tashia Phillips.
That's this pace of game. You know, we talked about the low scoring. Neither of these teams are necessarily pushing transition up tempo style, but right now it is quick paced.
Well, I think Pat's observation was right. They've seen each other, they've played each other, they have a feel for each other, and right now it's almost a stalemate.
Yeah, it is.
Jesse Wolf missing the free throw, talking about Phillips. She broke the record set by Vicki Hall, the 1988 Indianapolis Star Miss Basketball. And then on the 25th of November against Franklin Central, she broke Vicki's school record of career rebounds with 925.
Replacing a great player in Indiana basketball.
Yes.
Went out to Texas to play, played professionally for several years overseas and here in the States.
Well, she was something. Vicki
yep.
Hall was an outstanding player. 3 minutes to go in this contest. 36-33 in favor of Brebeuf. Left-handed layup off the mark by Curry. And Wawasee with the mark just under 3 minutes. And a knockdown three by Taylor Goshert. She has three field goals in this quarter. They've all come from outside, and we've got our first tie of the game at 36. So about the time you think somebody's going to exert themselves and take over the ball game, it goes the other way. Here's the three-point field goal. Wide open look. Nobody defensively out that time on Goshert.
Well, a nice reversal pass from Brennan McAdams, because that left Goshert wide open. Their last four field goals have all been two of those by Goshert and two of them by McAdams. So outstanding job from behind the arc. Right now, Wawasee shooting 5 for 14 from behind the arc. Brebeuf Jesuit only 1 for 6. They're not known for their three-point shooting.
Wawasee on a 12-7 run over the last minute 43 after being down by 5 points just a couple of seconds. It seems like a goal. They have come back to take the game into a tie at 36 for the first time in the ball game. Well, the pace of this game, I thought early on they were just running on adrenaline, but they're still going strong.
Yes, they are. Well, we knew that it was going to be the closest game of the day just because these two teams very evenly matched.
Wawasee with a chance to get the lead, and they throw it away.
Play very ragged, back and forth, out in front, turnovers, and a lot of heart and hustle. I guess that's the good positive part. We talk about an ugly game, but at least from the effort standpoint of view, it's been very good.
So Brebeuf will bring it back to the goal to our left with 2.5 minutes to go. Inside to Phillips, out of bounds. And that time they dropped two defenders on her, and as soon as she touched the basketball, she had company.
That makes a big difference. Phillips is able to make the move in the post if it's one-on-one. You drop two on her, she can't get that little gather dribble she likes to do, and you see her try to go to the baseline there and put the ball on the floor, and all she ran into was a green jersey.
Well, we'll see what happens now with Brebeuf, because they're going to have to focus, and here's a nice step-in steal this time by Phillips. They're going to focus on her to keep it both to her offensively and away from her defensively. So we'll see exactly how Wawasee wants to play this. She is still, she being Phillips, the key to the game so far for Brebeuf.
You see what Wawasee has done. They're sandwiching her. One in front, one in back. They're going to make somebody else beat them. And that is, well, it worked for a second.
It did. They got the ball to Alex Puckett. And Puckett just dropped it off down inside beautifully.
Puckett, a freshman, averages 2 points a game. Gets the ball at the high post. Let her have it. Let's see what she can do. If I'm Wawasee, I would not have rushed at her, and they did. And that left Phillips just enough space to be able to score.
Curry will pick up the personal foul.
Kim Zollman on the sideline talking to his players, in particular talking to Jesse Wolf, saying, don't leave Phillips. Stay down there. Make somebody else beat you at this point. At least I assume that's what he's telling me.
Yep, you got to figure no matter where the ball goes, if you've been assigned a defender, stay with her.
Yep.
Ball batted free, but still belongs to Brebeuf. A couple of substitutions now into the lineup for Brebeuf. 33, Paige Thomas returns. Sean Knapel, one of the starters, the 6'1 senior, comes back into the lineup for Wawasee. Wawasee, 22-3 on the year. They lost to East Noble, South Bend, Washington, whom we're going to see later, and also Brebeuf. So there are three losses to schools out of their bracket, except for the Brebeuf Jesuit loss. The other two schools are 4A classifications. Minute 15 to go here in the third quarter. Nice pass and a good shot from the baseline by Tara Weiser.
Tara Weiser had great position down inside on a steal. She didn't get the ball because she had to see a Phillips right behind her, and then decided better of it. So then she steps out on the baseline, and the kick then from Kayla Lance was very nice to leave her for a wide open jump shot. That's a little easier to go over Phillips.
Oh, absolutely. Nice play that time because they drew Phillips away from the receiver of the pass, and she had just a split second to get the shot away. So we're tied at 38 with a minute to play here in the third. They'll try to go in the middle again, and this time Tara Weiser steps in to make the defensive stop. Wawasee with a chance to regain the lead with 50 seconds to go in the third quarter. Lance, nowhere to go. Goshert, nowhere to go. Well, this is tenacious defense on both ends of the court.
Well, when you have a big 6'5 block, shot blocker behind you, you can afford to be a little more aggressive up top and get beat on penetration.
Loose ball picked up by Brebeuf, trying to get it up court. They finally do, into the hands of Newsom. And then they come up court and get it in the hands of Paige Thomas. And Thomas will miss the shot, but draw the foul and go to the line.
Boy, that ball was tipped all the way down. It's like every time Brebeuf tried to make a pass, Wawasee had a hand on it but could not secure the steal. And at least it stopped the easy layup, because that's exactly what it would have been for Thomas. And fortunately, because of those deflections, that's a stat a lot of coaches love. You don't keep it on the stat sheet, but deflections are something that are really important, because that means your teams are getting their hands in the passing lanes, making it difficult for the offensive team to make the pass clean.
Paige Thomas yet to score in this contest. 70% shooter, got double dipped, did not score either one of them. Rebound is loose and picked up, nobody, but last touch, they said, by Wawasee. In this quarter, Brebeuf is 1 out of 4 from the free throw line, but they've made up with it with Tashia Phillips scoring 9 points. Into the ball game for Wawasee, Jesse Wolf, 5'11 senior. So Brebeuf inbounds under their own hoop. They can find somebody. Ball was tipped and stolen away. Nice play by Brennan McAdams. And then they turn him out and throw it away at the other end of the court. But it was last touched by one of the Brebeuf players.
Another turnover for Brebeuf. That's their 17th. And we still have a quarter left to play. Now, Wawasee's not too far behind with 14.
Well, it's just the pace of the game, Jay. My goodness, it's just been hectic right from the get-go. be the end of the third quarter. So after a 20-19 lead by Brebeuf at halftime, they kick the lead up to five, but they also trail by two. As we go to the fourth quarter for the 3A championship, it's all tied up. It's 38-all. Well, it's pretty much like we talked about, Jane Schott, at the start of the telecast. We felt that on paper, these two clubs were almost identical, and the score would indicate so.
Their styles are different. They're both very good defensive teams, but one does it with a big 6'5 post presence in Brebeuf, Tashia Phillips. The other one does it with just hounding lots of pressure defense. You can see Wawasee is very high energy on the defensive end. And so both teams have kept the score low and made it a kind of a battle, I guess you would say, offensively, just because of that good defense.
They go inside to Phillips, knocked away, and last touch by Wawasee. Tashia Phillips right now with 23 points in the game. She has four rebounds and four block shots, and she had those four early in the game. Here's the three off the mark. Good push off that time by Lance to get position. It's out of bounds, belongs to Wawasee. Wawasee shooting 14 of 40 for 35%. They've improved a little bit. 16 of 30 for Brebeuf, 53%. 14 turnovers for 12 points for Wawasee. Brebeuf has turned the ball over 17 times, and that's turned into 13 points for Wawasee.
Well, Phillips is 11 for 13 from the field. The rest of her team is 5 for 17. You expect that. She shoots 76% on the season. Part of that is she's pretty close and tight.
Here's a steal by Curry.
A good read by Callie Curry. Another turnover for Wawasee.
Kelly with her first field goal since the opening quarter of play. She had a field goal then, a couple of free throws in the second quarter, and the lead goes to 40-38 in favor of Brebeuf. Wearing the gold uniforms in green, Wawasee, the 3A championship for the Indiana High School Athletic Association on the line from Conseco Fieldhouse. And what a game it has been. Not pretty by any stretch of the imagination, but competitive, you got it, right from the very get-go of this game. 10-9, Brebeuf at the end of the first quarter. 20-19, Brebeuf at the halfway mark, and tied at 38 after three quarters. Wide open look by Thomas, nothing doing there. And two green shirts inside. Good job on the defensive boards that time.
And they've done a pretty good job of keeping Phillips off the offensive glass for the most part.
Traveling violation, and that time was caused. McAdams got inside, and all of a sudden, there's Phillips.
Yeah, you see the defense there by Brebeuf on the reversal pass. Callie Curry read it perfectly. She goes in for the uncontested. Nice job by the 5'7 junior.
Lauren Meadows back in the ball game now for Brebeuf Jesuit. They bring Phillips out of the high post right now, put her right at the free throw stripe. Wherever she goes, Kadathan is going right there with her. Wide open look out front by Obeime. And a turnover again.
I think she actually thought about kicking it down low, had a high-low look, but Wawasee is doing exactly what their coach said. Do not leave Phillips and leave that high post wide open. So Obeime had a nice 15-footer, but I think she panicked a little bit.
I think she did. I think she looked inside to try to get the ball to Phillips and then shuffled her feet. Couple of minutes gone in the fourth quarter, 40-38 basketball game. Low scoring, we thought so. Another block this time by Phillips. That'll give her at least five for the game.
Goshert had nowhere to go. Went down to the baseline. Couldn't get a pass back out. Was about ready to get a five-second call. So she just went ahead and tried to draw the foul. But Phillips goes up over top for yet another block.
Well, that's scary. That's a new record, by the way. Five. Banking it in right front. Good work by Jesse Wolf that time. Wolf on the scoreboard for the first time for the field. She had a free throw, a couple of free throws up earlier. And she has 3 points so far in the contest. Basket is good.
Tashia Phillips gets inside again. You see the nice pass to the high post. When she gets at the high post, she's going to drive to the right. I mean, she can go in the low block. She can go right or left. She's very good at both. But she's a right-handed player. If she's gonna put the ball on the floor, it's gonna be to the right. You gotta know that from a scouting report and make her go to the left, and she will not be able to drive all the way to the basket to get the potential and final three-point play there.
Yeah, what do we say? She was averaging 26 points a game in the tournament play. What's she got right now? She's got 26 points.
Well, we still got 5:36 left to play.
Now she's on her way to a big night, and we figured that was going to be the case, that they'd have to go to her inside. Wallace, he's done a nice job with her. Here's a foul, almost a steal, but the personal foul on Obeime. That'll be two on her. They've done everything they can do, manpower-wise. They've doubled, they've high-loaded her, they've done everything. They've bumped her, but she's still going to get her points.
Yeah, she is. You got to credit her teammates for getting her the basketball in a nice spot. Right now, Brebeuf has 11 assists on those 18 field goals. And a lot of those assists are coming directly from passing the ball into Tashia Phillips.
5:25 to go now in this contest. 43-40 in favor of Brebeuf. They lead by three. They've led by five. They've trailed by two. We've had we've had three lead changes in the game and a couple of ties. It'll be Wawasee's basketball. We mentioned that this will be the second state championship for Brebeuf. It would be the first for Wawasee. They were runners-up back in 85, back in the single class days when Crown Point got them. It was back when Tom May was coaching that Crown Point powerhouse. 5 minutes exactly to play. 43-40, Brebeuf.
And now, look at Tashia Phillips coming out on Knafel. And that's something Wallace's got to attack that. When if she's out away from the basket, that's when you take it at him.
That's your one hope to get inside when she's not there.
But now they've lost their opportunity because Phillips is back down on the block. Wallace trying to do a 1-4 low where you've got a guard up top. And that time it was McAdams trying to penetrate the basket. I'm not sure that's a great idea when Phillips is down low, because it's going to make it tough.
30-second timeout. And again, what happened was as soon as McAdams picked up her dribble, boy, they doubled her down low and she had nowhere to go. Let's put a little package together on Phillips. She's something else.
Well, you can see the nice move inside. Little post move on previous, and she gets offensive rebound. The high low look, she seals very nicely, has good position. And these are all easy baskets for her. That's all due to the work that she does prior to getting the basketball. All the footwork, the ceiling, all of that. She's an excellent post player in that respect. And her teammates are doing a great job getting her the ball.
Well, you hate to keep focusing on her, but right now she's the key to the basketball game.
She really is. If Wawasee can slow her down, you know, they'll have a better chance of coming through here in the end.
That time she just bottled things up. It's out of bounds. Belongs to Wawasee. Even when she's not part of the play, she's part of the play. They're aware of where she is.
Yeah. Call that presence. Post presence.
Absolutely.
Just a presence in general.
Yeah.
She has it on both ends of the floor.
And you can almost see from time to time Wawasee looking to find out where she is before they do whatever it is they want to do. So you're kind of distracted to a certain degree.
Well, I think one player that's been affected is Taylor Goshert. Goshert had 29 in the semi-state last week. She was awesome. Part of that is she can penetrate very well. She hadn't been able to do that tonight.
Absolutely not. Now they're still only down by 3 points and very, very much in this basketball game.
Well, Goshert has found other ways to score. She has 13. She just hasn't been able to get into the paint off of penetration.
McAdams got inside, but nowhere to go, and the ball just soaring away. A pickpocket move that time by Paige Thomas. Thomas comes down to the near side, and a good defensive play by McAdams at the other end. The sophomore in a hurry the other way, and blocked again by Tashia Phillips at six.
Phillips just lets people get past her sometimes so she can get the block on that. Taylor Goshert trying to go up as you see the pass ahead on the layup and the big time Phillips block.
3-point lead for Brebeuf. 43-40 Brebeuf. In the third quarter, they had 7 field goals and 4 of the 7 were the 3-point variety. So they've used the outside game very effectively.
Well, it's kept them in it. You see Brendan McAdams get to go right down there, and she gets another one on the wing. And then Taylor Goshert gets into the act. She's hit 3 in the second half herself. So those 3 balls have kept Wawasee in this game and close to Brebeuf.
Goshert had 44 coming into the game. 30 for Megan Walker, 20 for Kaylin Lance. So they've got some ladies who can shoot from outside. And they may have to go that way right now. They're down by three with 3:48 to play, and the 3A title is on the line.
Well, they shoot 33% from behind the arc on the season, and they're close to that here tonight.
Nice inbounds play, but once again, the entire thing messed up. Double dribble. The entire thing messed up by Tashia Phillips. They ran the inbounds play beautifully, and under normal conditions, they'd have probably a wide-open 10-foot shot, but nothing there because Phillips recovered so dramatically and so quickly to mess things up inside.
Yeah. Yep, she's got that presence on the interior. The one thing Wawasee can do is when somebody does penetrate, they need to find those spot ups. They're having a tendency to stand and watch, and they're getting stuck. You can't do that. If you'll move to where your penetrator can see, she can kick it to you and you get a wide open jump shot.
Well, here comes Brebeuf. They lead with 3 minutes and 40 seconds to go. They've got the margin up to three. They've had it as high as five. A lot of turnovers in the game. There's another one right there. That's 9, that's 20 now for Brebeuf. As they continue to struggle with the basketball, somehow managed to maintain the lead. Now the turnover in the other way. Nope, saved by Wawasee. Ninth effort that time by Brendan McAdams. Inside, stolen away. In a hurry, getting up court. Ivie Obeime.
That's a nice move by Obeime off the turnover. Boy, Jerry, are we seeing a very different game tonight than we saw this afternoon? Remember, Heritage Christian only had 5 turnovers when they played this afternoon against. They only had 11 turnovers, and both of these teams have more by themselves than those two teams did together.
Well, it's a turnover and then a reach-in foul to follow up on the turnover.
You saw Ivie Obeime taking it hard to the glass, little hesitation on going up, lets the defense slide by her. A nice move by the 5'10 junior.
That last foul was on Brennan McAdams, the 5'9 sophomore, and that's number 4 on her. But at this point of the game, there's not much that Kim Zolman can do as far as taking her out and letting her rest. Phillips way off the mark. Might have got tapped on the elbow that time. Saved on the far sideline in front of a Brebeuf bench. Thrown back into one of the Wawasee players. So Brebeuf will get it with 2 minutes and 44 seconds to go.
Well, you always see someone come off the bench and give you a lift. And right now for Brebeuf, it's Ivie Obeime. She goes and gets the nice save and gets her team fired up.
Traveling violation by Aisha Newsom, the 5'5 freshman. She was the only open player that time. They got it to her beautifully, and she just shuffled her feet. There's Kendall. Her grandfather, Jerry, coached Evansville Bossy to the state finals in 84, lost in the afternoon game, and she had to play down at Evansville last week. Kind of an emotional situation for her and her team, but they got the job done down in Jeffersonville as they came away with that victory. Over Evansville Bossy, the number 9 team of the state. 3-point field goal.
Kayla Lance has been the emotional leader here for the Warriors. At that last dead ball, she was trying to urge the fans to get up and cheer, and then she comes down and gives them something to cheer about with the big three.
And right at the other end, look who that is again. There's Ivie Obeime.
Well, pay too much attention to Tashia Phillips. That's going to leave somebody open. Obeime's taking advantage of it.
We're less than 2 minutes away from the end of the game at 47-43. Another three-pointer rattles in and out that time by Goshert. Goshert with 13 points, and boy, she could have used that one because that would have really tightened things up with a minute 45 to play. Now we'll see what Brebeuf does. Will they spread the floor and try to kill some time? Bounce pass in wide side to Obeime. She's really been a key here in the last couple of minutes. They go right back to her again, and the whistle will stop play, and a 30-second timeout taken by Kendall Kleinhagen. Mark Collins, Nick Austin, Denise McDonald, and Kristen Comer are her assistants for Kim Zolman, Rocky Goshert, Roger Brady, Jamie McAdams, all working hard on the Warriors side of the bench. Hey, fans, stay with us now. We got the big South Bend, Washington game coming up against Columbus East. You're going to see a couple of outstanding players individually on both of these clubs. We'll talk about them when we get to that juncture, and two really good basketball teams, so hang around for that. Brebeuf won the state championship in 04 in 3A. They beat Fort Wayne Lures 54-38. Kendall Kleinhagen's championship team 26-3 that year. Wawasee, you got to go back to 85 in single-class basketball when they lost to Crown Point 48-31. They had a 23-2 record that year under Dale Brannick. So they're looking for their first state championship.
I remember sitting on the baseline of that game and watching. That was an outstanding game. Not Tom May's Crown Point Bulldogs.
Yeah, back then, Tom, who is still a friend of mine, He just had a powerhouse on the ground.
Yeah, he did, and still does a great job. But well, he had some tremendous players, Annie Kovachkov, and quite a few that went through his program to kind of put them on the map, so to speak.
That's the foul on Goshert, number three on her. A minute and a half to go on the game. They need a defensive stop. Does Wawasee? Lots of pressure, but now they're moving back outside the long range to Lauren Meadows, and we've got it right over here in our hands.
Kendall Kreinhagen taking that timeout, sensing her teammate was a little rattled. They're up by four. This is a very critical possession, and Brebeuf wants to make sure that they either get a score or they don't let Wawasee go down and get a quick score themselves.
A minute 24 to play. This along the baseline.
Allie Curry taking it hard to the basket. She's going to go to the free throw line, a 72% free throw shooter, so not a bad option for offense for the Brebeuf Braves. Curry today so far, 2 for 2 from the free throw line.
They put that foul on Jesse Wolf. That's the first of the ball game. Will be 5'11 senior. Free throws, oh, how big are they? This one will not go. Curry with 6 points. She had 4 in the first half. And his 1 field goal here in the fourth quarter. Curry's a 72% free throw shooter. As a club, they shoot right at 61%. And she missed them both, and the rebound is fought for. A held ball, possession arrow, Wawasee.
Now the basket gets a little smaller when you get within the 2-minute mark of the game, and Curry, a very good free throw shooter, but she looked like she tried to guide those in. Looked a little tight on those, and they were important. She knew it. And Wawasee still has a little bit of life left in them. They feel like now they've got their second chance to see what they can do, go down on the offensive end.
Almost a must-score possession, though. Would you not think, Jane?
Yes, I believe so. Because if not, they're going to have to start fouling, and then it becomes a different game.
And a steal. Nice play by Curry again. And a whistle again and a foul call. Boy, Curry did a super job of reading that play and making the interception.
Fifth steal for Callie Curry. As you see, McAdams trying to get down on the penetration and kick it. Curry read it perfectly. Went right to where the pass was going. Tips it to Shia Phillips, who's now a senior, is going to go to the free throw line to try to add to her 26 points.
She's 2 out of 5 for the free throw stripe. 26 points in the ball game. Misses the shot, and again, that rim just gets smaller and smaller. Held ball, possession arrow. Rebuff this time.
All right, I'll tell you, free throws are going to become a key if they might come back to haunt you. Brebeuf right now only 6 for 16 from the free throw line. Their lead could be bigger right now, Jerry.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you talk. I don't suppose there's ever a coach to tell practice that somewhere along the way you don't shoot free throws. I mean, you just know they're going to be a factor in the game, but somehow things change under the gun.
Yep.
1:11 to play. They go to Phillips. Phillips' basket went in, but it will not count. Foul somebody called instead against Wawasee.
Well, you know, Jerry, this is a little bit of reminiscent of Hackershack in there.
Yes.
That's not a bad foul because Phillips, you don't foul her, she's going to score 2. You foul her, I mean, there's at least a chance that she may miss because she's only a 65% free throw shooter. On the day, she has struggled a little bit. She's only 2 for 6.
This one is good.
And she's too big that just to shut me up. I'm supposed to stick up for the post players, you know?
I guess you are.
I'm not doing a very good job of that, am I?
27 points now for Tashia Phillips. She has just been sensational in the tournament. She's had games of 28, 13, 29, 13, 30. Now check it, 22, 25, 32, 26, 22, and 30. She has been sensational. Here's the missed shot, and the rebound put back up, no good. Phillips trying for the offensive board, and Wawasee will knock it out of bounds.
Bodies are flying everywhere that time. Ivie Obeime, who has had an outstanding second half here for Brebeuf, got jumped on, I think, maybe by Tashia Phillips, going hard for the board. And then as Goshert tried to track down the ball, she falls and goes hard to the floor. So both teams just laying it out on the line here in the last minute of trying to win a state championship.
Well, they laid it on the line at the opening tip of the game, for crying out loud.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
I mean, this has been one of those games where ask and get nothing. I mean, you ask for no excuses and you get none. And here's a really hard foul right in front of us here. It'll be against Wawasee, but they're in a position now where they just don't have many opportunities. The foul's going to be on Taylor Goshert. I've got her for 4.
Obeime trying to protect the basketball. And got to be a little careful. I'd have to see the replay to know if she swung, but there was contact.
Yeah, there was.
And Goshert, you know, it was almost like she was trying to take a charge, even though there was no real in her shot or anything like that.
So. Well, Baby's first trip to the free throw line tonight. She comes in shooting only 49% from the stripe. She'll miss the first one. Ivy averaging 5.5 points, has 8. Substitution now for Wawasee. Megan Walker, the 5'4 senior, returns to the lineup, heading out of the ballgame. Kylie Orth, the sophomore. And again, the free throw is so important. Well, 48-43.
In the last 2.5 minutes, Brebeuf has only hit 2 out of 8. And Obeime gets one of those right there.
9 points now for Ivy, the 5'10 junior. Less than a minute to play. They've got to go to the outside shot, apparently, because there's just nothing going inside. Now they do try to go inside. Here's the shot. It is up for the count.
Nope, they're going to call it before the shot. Knafel got held. Unfortunately, it would have been a nice lift for her team as the crowd reacts behind us. You see her going inside right there. But there's the grab before. That's a good call. You know, that would be a big continuation if you called that on the shot, and it was not. It was before.
Obeime's third personal foul. Tashia, again, a factor. If they give her a blocker, that'll be, I believe, 7 on the game.
Yep, they did give it to her, and I thought she got a little tip on it. 7 block shots. She's now chasing the 10 block shots that we saw earlier today. Wood Memorial. You and I, we've done too many games. Katie Cochran.
I kept forgetting her name. Wow, she had a triple-double.
How could you forget her?
I don't know.
She's 6'6 and had a tremendous game.
Yes,
I think it's because we're trying to call 4 games in one day, maybe.
And we got another one to go, so hang in there.
Yeah, we're ready. But Tashia Phillips has 7. She's not quite up there with Katie Cochran yet in terms of block shots. However, Phillips just hits a free throw, and now she has 28, make it 29.
Well, she's got a good-looking shot, too.
Yeah, she does.
29 points for Tashia Phillips, and another block. Now we're down to 35 seconds to go in this ball game. Now you have no choice. They'll start committing the fouls, and that's about all they can possibly do. It looks like Brebeuf is going to pick up another championship. They have had state champions in 10 different events. Boys basketball in 2000, they've won a title in boys tennis. Of course, at one time, they had the powerhouse girls tennis team of the state, winning state titles in 79, 80, 81, 83, and 84. And they've won 2 volleyball state championships. So a total of 10 overall state championships for Brebeuf. First free throw is off the mark. For Wawasee, they have 1 state championship. That's girls track back in 1976. So the first free throw is off the mark, and we'll get a timeout with 35.8 remaining and a 51-43 lead. That's the biggest lead of the ball game for Brebeuf. And just to kind of recap things for you, Brebeuf led at the end of the first 10-9. They're at halftime, they were up still by 1, 20-19. A great effort by Wawasee in the third quarter, tied it after 3 at 38. Since then, we've had we've had 3 lead changes, a couple of ties at 36 and 38. And the biggest lead for Wawasee in the entire game was 2. And when they did get that 2-point lead, that's when Brebeuf went on a little bit of a run and kind of established themselves as the leader. And so far, they've been able to hold off the Wawasee Warriors. Don't forget, now coming up after this game, we'll have all the ceremonies, the presentation of the Pat Roy Mental Attitude Award. And then, of course, we have the medallions to be handed out, the state runner-up trophy, the state championship, and then South Bend, Washington, and Columbus East. And that has all of the makings of a terrific basketball game. You saw the 8 block shots, a Class 3A record, but earlier today we saw the 10 block shots turned in. So here's Phillips again at the line.
Well, Phillips has still got 35 seconds, Jerry. We'll see if she can get a couple more. She just had 6, and then the last 30 seconds, she picked up 2 more. Yep. So right now, Wawasee trying to make something happen. So they're going at her. Phillips is just waiting down there.
She missed both free throws. Final 30 seconds of the ball game. 31 seconds to play. Shot at the free throw line. Nothing. Off into the hands of Phillips. They'll hustle it back up court. Go right hard to the hoop and draw the foul.
Phillips close to a well, close to a double-double, but also close to a triple-double. 29 points, 9 boards, and 8 block shots. So a good evening for her, but I think it's her teammates who've stepped up and provided the lift that they needed to get out ahead, particularly Ivie Obeime coming up big in the second half. She's 4-for-6 from the field for 9 points.
Yeah, you look at it, you say, man, Phillips carried the team. Well, she did to a certain degree. The free throw is off the mark. But Obeime, in that little segment of what, a couple of minutes, was a major player.
Right, because at that point, Wawasee, it was right after Wawasee was tied up, and Phillips had a three-point play to go up 3, and then Obeime took over and scored the next 4 points. Remember, off of the turnover?
Yep.
And then she got inside for the nice post move as they take Tashia Phillips out.
And Tashia's coming out of the ball game right now with 29 points, 9 rebounds, 8 block shots. Thank you, Tim. Second shot, no good. Rebound taken down by Obeime again. And now with 15 seconds to go in the contest, it looks like Brebeuf has got this baby wrapped up. But the fierceness, the competitiveness of this thing has just been unbelievable. Another turnover, and now we'll get a masked substitution. Wawasee will send in some players who haven't had any playing time on the court, perhaps.
Well, you know, you got to give credit to Wawasee. They played their hearts out. They played hard the whole game. Every time it looked like Brebeuf might run away with it, they battled back and found a way to score. So this Wawasee team has nothing to be ashamed of.
Well, they've done a terrific job. They just simply had no answer for Tashia Phillips. And that's the ball game. So the crowd crossed the way, wrecked out in that maroon and gold outfit with celebration on their mind. The final score is Brebeuf 51 and Wawasee 43. Pretty much, I think, Jane Schott, what we thought was going to happen. Was hard to pick a favorite in this game, and with the exception of a couple of instances within the game, it was pretty much even Steven.
Yeah, it really was a very hard-fought game and an extremely defensive-minded. Boy, it was just tough. Both teams turning the ball over a lot, so it was sluggish at times, but still a lot of effort. And you got to give credit to the Brebeuf Braves. They stuck to their game plan. They got the ball to the big center, and she carried them to a state championship.
Well, the celebration will continue now. They'll bring out the platforms, and the first item of business will be the Pat Roy Mental Attitude Award. Pat Roy was a former coach and athletic director out at Ben Davis High School, a member of the IHSAA staff, and that's whom the award is named after. Let's go to JMB.
All right. Thank you, Jerry Baker. Well, tell me how this feels.
Pretty good. Pretty gosh darn good, that's for sure.
You got a lot of long weeks, long days. It seems all worth it now, I assume.
You know, it's just wonderful for these kids and how hard they've worked this week and their focus, and right down here to the end, they had a fight. That's a gritty Wawasee team, and it feels wonderful.
You know, Tashia Phillips was huge, we know that, but Ivy, I thought, was the difference maker down the stretch, maybe the last 4 minutes of that fourth quarter.
Ivy Obeime was flat out awesome. You know, she was just an athlete out there, and it's an athlete that I don't think that they had that could stop her. And she came up with some huge, huge rebounds. I think that's the first game all year we've had somebody other than Tashia Phillips be our leading rebounder.
Does this seem all worthwhile now?
Oh, yeah, it does, definitely.
Congratulations, Coach. Go celebrate.
Thank you very much.
Jerry Baker, back to you.
Thank you, JMV. Let's go up to the platform. Deb Stevens, a member of the IHSAA Board of Directors out of Caston High School, is about to make the announcement of the Mental Attitude Award winner.
To deserving high school students in our state, on behalf of the IHSAA, please join us by saying thank you to Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance for its generous support of our student athletes. After we announce the name of the recipient, we invite her parents to join her on the arena floor. The recipient of this award, while a student in grade 12, was nominated by the principal and coach, excelled in mental attitude, athletic ability, scholarship, and leadership during the 4 years of high school, participated as a state finalist in his sport, and was selected by members of the IHSA Executive Committee. The winner of the 2007 Patricia L. Roy Mental Attitude Award for Class 3A Girls Basketball is Megan Walker of Wawasee.
You see Megan Walker there getting hugs for her teammate. She ranks third in her class of 195 students, a member of the National Honor Society and the Student Council, and she is a vice president. So nice to see a kid like that. I think the most interesting thing is, Jerry, she's still a three-sport athlete. In the age when a three-sport athlete is difficult to do, she's going to graduate with 12 varsity letters probably.
Wow.
How tremendous is that? Megan Walker up there with her parents, Kevin and Cheryl. She plans to major in pharmacy at Butler University. So even though she's upset her team lost, she's got to feel a little pride and joy, particularly her mom and dad at this moment.
This has got to be so hard on the youngster. And I've been doing these games forever. And every time I see the youngster winning the Mental Attitude Award that's on the losing team, they're not quite sure what to do.
Right.
They're very happy they won, but they're still, their body is saying, we didn't win the championship.
Right, exactly.
Well, we're going to take a break, and then we'll come back, and we'll try to talk to Megan and some other folks as Brebeuf wins the state championship in Class 3A. A couple of numbers, notations. First off, the most losses ever by a state championship team was 7. Triton, 20-7 in 2000, and North Central Indianapolis at 20-7 likewise in 2005, along with Tri-Central at 19-7 in 2005 in Class A. So with the victory, Brebeuf finishes up 23-6 on the year. So they are among the leaders as far as most losses by a championship team. And you also ran across an interesting number there.
Well, Tashia Phillips with her 29 points ranks second now in top scoring of 4A teams, right behind Racina Russell, who had 31 in 2002 for Tower Hope South.
Yep.
And now she's in the record books. Tashia Phillips is second with 29.
Well, there is Tashia. I know we've talked a lot about her tonight, and you try to spread the wealth around a little bit, but she was just a sensational player tonight.
Well, you got to credit her teammates for getting her the basketball. A lot of times they were passing it into her for her to do the work, and you know that says a lot about that group. You can give up your own personal stats and things like that for what's to be best for the team. As you see Wawasee right there, they were a consummate team themselves, Class 3A state runner-ups.
That was their 7th Mental Attitude Award, by the way. Jennifer Cox won it in 76 in girls gymnastics. Lorene Spearman in 78, girls track and field. Brad Traviolia in 85 for football. Corey Lance in football in 04. Wrestling, Lance in 86. And the 94 boys swimming and diving, Andy Kreider. So they have 7 Mental Attitude Awards. Still looking for their first girls basketball state championship. As we mentioned earlier, they won the state title in girls track in 76. Now comes the presentation of the Brebeuf Jesuit Class 3A championship medallions. And the young ladies will be traipsing up on the platform. Let's just pick up a little bit of this. Members of the IHSAA board handing out the medallions.
Aisha Newsom.
Some of the students who have earned the right to kind of be a part of this ceremony. That's who that young lady is right there. They have a student committee.
Tiffany Bird.
Well, this will continue on with each of the individual players and coaches, and we'll come back with the championship trophy presentation in just a moment. Brebeuf 51, Wawasee 43 for the Class 3A championship. You know, we have not made mention of this throughout the game. Tashia Phillips, who talked about her being a senior, and we've not made any talk about where she's going to college. We want to touch on that in a couple of minutes. Remind me to do that. Let's go over to JMB first, though.
Hey, I'll be your personal reminder, Jerry Baker. Okay. Thank you very much. Ken Zolm is the head coach of Wawasee. I know, Coach, this is not how you wanted this to end this season, but certainly it's been a fun ride.
It's been a fun ride. You know, you get down here, one of them is going to lose. And our kids, I'm so proud of every one of them, that how they just continued to battle all year long, and they just did a really super job. The Phillips girl's true. She's for real. And so it's just a matter of a time that we just really work hard at doing what we got to do, and the kids just didn't work out for us.
Coach, you got to go. Congratulations on a great season.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Here's your reminder, Bake, back to you.
Thank you, By the way, I talked with Cam just briefly before the game. I talked to him on Monday. What a very nice man he is. And here comes the trophy presentation, the championship trophy presentation, and our congrats to Brebeuf. We were talking about Tashia Phillips. Now, originally, she had made a verbal commitment to go to Purdue University, but that has changed.
That has, and she has not signed a letter of intent, so I'm sure there's quite a few college coaches that are watching this game with interest or wanting to know how it turns out for Tashia Phillips. She will sign in the spring and make her decision. I know that there are still some schools involved in her top list, and whoever gets her, what a gem you've got. I mean, I think, you know, obviously a great basketball body. She can score inside, but she seems to be such a pleasant young woman as well, very intelligent. I think that her basketball intelligence shows on the floor by her body positioning, and, you know, wherever she goes, she's going to make an impact.
Well, if you're going to Brebeuf, you're a pretty smart young lady already. So the final again is 51-43. 3A title is belonging in the halls of Brebeuf Jesuit Preparatory School. Well, cutting down the nets here at Conseco Fieldhouse. I was just kind of following Teresa Wins around. Teresa's one of the assistant commissioners for the IHSAA, and she's kind of hobbled a little bit. She busted her foot up about a week or so ago, and she's out there right now trying to make sure everything gets along well. I'm sure her husband Joe was taking real good care of her, you know.
Just watching out for her.
Yeah, I'm sure he is. I know Joe, yeah. There's Teresa now. She's kind of wandering around out there. She said a lot of work that goes into this. We're enjoying some of the post-game festivities now as the Nets come down at Conseco Fieldhouse, and Brebeuf will pick up this championship, and our congrats going out to the Braves tonight. And Kendall Kreinhagen, in her fifth year now, has won 98 games and lost only 33. Graduate of Evansville Wrights High School and the University of Indianapolis, and JMV now has our Medal Attitude Award winner.
It's just on a great performance and a great season. How's it feel?
Thanks. It feels amazing. You know, a lot of people thought that we weren't going to do it in the beginning, but we proved it to ourselves and everybody else. The looks on these girls' faces is just enough.
Your coach was telling me at the half, you know what, we're kind of getting out scrapped. Did she say that to you in the locker room at the half?
Actually, she told us that, you know, we were getting outworked, and we decided all as a team that we would come out and outwork them and do what we needed to do the second half.
Congratulations on a great season.
Thank you. Appreciate
Jerry
it.
Baker, back to you.
Yeah, my apologies. That was, of course, Tashia Phillips, who was just dominant in this game today with 29 points, second all-time in points scored in the class basketball in the years we've had the four different classes. And what they've done now, they've all huddled over in front of the Brebeuf cheering section. They'll have the official photo taken in a matter of moments. And there's Teresa managing the traffic over there. We'll take another break and then we'll come back, and the festivities continue. There's that championship trophy that belongs proudly to Brebeuf Jesuit. Activities continue, the admiration of that championship trophy. We mentioned earlier, Mike Marshall is the athletic director at Brebeuf Preparatory School. He took that job a couple of months ago, and he is right now with JMV.
Yeah, I mean, but I'm like, oh, hey, I guess I'm here. I don't know if I have a camera on me or not, but I'm with Mike Marshall, the former Butler Bulldog, the current AD at Brebeuf. Hey, how's this feel? You come along, they win a title, that's pretty easy, huh?
Yeah, I wish it was all due to me. As you know, I mean, we have an All-American in the middle. She's unbelievable, but she's got great teammates that pick her up. And Coach Kreinhagen's been there, done that.
What do you think? I mean, is it a lot different? I mean, you've been such a college guy in the past. What's the difference?
Pure enthusiasm. These kids play because they love playing the game. Most of them won't play after college, so they got their chance to win a championship, and they went out and did it.
You know what they do now, AD? They put on your desk, well, we're expected to win a title each and every year. You understand that, don't you?
Well, I know. I said I don't want to be like Tubby Smith, win my first year, and then everyone is over me every other year.
Right, before I let you go, I have to ask. Butler today, semifinals, Horizon League tournament in Dayton, an overtime winner by a point, got done. Now, were you maybe looking at the score on a cell phone in the stands while this game was going on, or did somebody tell you?
Someone told me, but we're definitely texting back and forth with all the employees over there to make sure that we know what's going on.
There you go. They might get Wright State. The winner of Wright State and, somebody else coming up tomorrow. But they got Loyola. They knocked down a Demon. And, of course, they're playing for a Horizon League title coming up. Hey, thanks for the time. Appreciate you. And, of course, great job in your first year as AD at Brebeuf.
Thank you.
That's Mike Marshall. Back to you, Bake.
I did not know the Butler scored. Appreciate that, JMV. Well, that program has just been remarkable out at Hinkle Fieldhouse and the Butler Bulldogs. Well, we wish them the very, very best. That game about wore me out.
Well, it was a tough one. I think the players were worn out. I know there were bodies flying all over, both teams laying it out on the floor and doing a great job. And it was a grinded out kind of win. I mean, if you like those, you know, tough-minded defensive games,
and
you would have loved this kind of ugly game. It definitely wasn't very offensively pretty, but at the same time, a very hard-fought game and an interesting one because I thought Brebeuf did a good job of getting out in the lead, and Wawasee always battled back until the end. They just couldn't get some shots to go down.
One note of explanation, we made an attempt to get Megan Walker, the Medal Attitude Award winner, but Kim decided once they had made all the presentations of the medals and the trophies that he took his team off the floor, and that's his perfect right, and we take no offense to that whatsoever. I wanted to explain that's why we did not get a chance to talk to our Medal Attitude Award winner. Well, the floor is being cleared right now. The new nets are already up, and we're going to getting ready for what I think to be a win of a 4A championship game, so stick around. 4A title game is on its way. Well, we are back now in South Bend, Washington, has just made its appearance on the floor, so we're going to go back and take a look. 51-43 your final. Brebeuf Jesuit. Now here comes Columbus East, the Olympians out. Let's go back and take a look at the keys to that first game and see how much of this came true. I know one of the things you talked about was control the tempo. I don't think either one of the teams controlled the tempo.
I agree. That ended up not being a factor. I think because the main key was Brebeuf established the post presence with Tashia Phillips and everything else went out the window. Controlling the tempo, you've got to take care of the basketball in order to do that. And neither team did that very well with 44 total turnovers between the two teams.
And, of course, the low-scoring game would have been in favor of Wawasee. And not that they let a lot of points in on the board. 51's not a lot of points, but they just could not get the offense going. Let's take a look at some of the highlights of this first game. You're going to see a lot of inside play from Tashia and some pretty good outside shooting, too.
Oh, we saw the drive there by Callie Curley early on because Phillips clears some space, but then the response by Brenda McAdams to get the 10-foot jumper to go down, and then Phillips goes to work. Down low in the post, they didn't have an answer for her either on the offensive glass or in the low post block move. She did a nice job, but Wawasee kept answering. They hit five trays in a row to keep them close right there. Phillips shows her block shot ability. Kylie Ortman goes in strong to try to pull up a jump shot. Just too much, Phillips.
Yeah.
That's what it all boiled down to. Brebeuf doing a great job of getting the big center of the basketball. In the second half, you see Taylor, she docks it out in the three to keep it close. Phillips again gets fouled on the inside and able to knock it down. But then she got a lot of help from her teammates as you see them knocking down the jump shots. More threes by Wawasee. They just kept lighting it up from the outside. But it wasn't enough as the defense prevailed. Kylie Curley getting the steal, the going down. And then you see the big shot by block shot by Phillips.
And that, my friend, is the Pizza Hut highlights. Favorite plays of the game. Plays, because there were so many really good plays in this game. And Kendall Kreinhagen picks up that championship, and now we're looking live at Conseco Fieldhouse. And that team to the right is Columbus East. I had a chance to watch them last Saturday down at Southport. This is a very, very good basketball team. And South Bend, Washington, finished up the year ranked number two in the state. The number one team at 4A was Hamilton Southeastern. A lot of folks thought that they would be here, but they found the going simply too tough. And South Bend, Washington is here. Number nine was Columbus East. Let's take a look at some numbers, some final numbers on this 3A championship game. 32% shooting for Wawasee and 20 of 39. That's not bad shooting. That's over 50% there for Brebeuf.
Well, a lot of that because it was much of it was in points in the paint. And if you look at the stats, 36 points in the paint for Brebeuf to only 10 for Wawasee. That's the difference in the ball game.
Now the rebound advantage, not much. Brebeuf 33 to 31 there. I'm just looking to see if anything jumps out. Goshert, we had kind of focused on her. We thought that Taylor might be the one that could carry Wawasee. She did not have a good shooting night, 5 of 19.
Yeah, tough day for the sophomore. Still played very hard, picks up three rebounds to go along with those 13 points, but she just couldn't find the range today, couldn't do it.
And Tachia Phillips, we talked a lot about her, 12 of 15 from the field, did not attempt a three-pointer. Free throws, if there was one deficiency, it had to be at the free throw line. She was only 5 of 12.
Yeah, her whole team didn't shoot the free throw very well, and you know, had Wawasee come back to win that basketball game, you would have looked at those free throws as being the difference, but it didn't, and so Brebeuf escapes by going inside and getting points in the paint.
I didn't realize this, so I look at the numbers here, but Brebeuf attempted 26 free throws. They hit 10 of 26, and Wawasee got to the line only 7 times. They hit 5 out of 7. Part of that is because when the ball went inside, they had no choice, Jane. They simply had to go in and bang Tashia or whoever else was in there.
Right. Phillips did a good job of plugging up the middle. So a lot of times you get to the free throw line because you're able to penetrate. Your dribble drive can create free throw opportunities. But Wawasee didn't have any of those opportunities, so they didn't get to the free throw line as much.
Also on Tashia's numbers, 9 rebounds and 8 block shots, which is their new record for 3A, but not a new record because earlier today we saw that record busted with 10 block shots in the game. Nothing else really jumps out at you. 6 of 18 three-point attempts for Wawasee. They really were forced to go outside because the inside game, I think it became apparent early on that was not going to work.
Yeah, and they did. They got shot 33% from the behind the arc, and that's what they do on the season. So you can't ask any more of those kids. They tried to knock down some shots, and they weren't able to go up against a good Brebeuf defense that just shut them down from the inside and out.
So Brebeuf finishes up 23-6, Wawasee 22-4.